Hello everyone, I'm Val from Motion Boutique. Today we're going to learn how to make this animation using our Newton4 products, Plotter, but also layer generators. I'm also going to use ChatGPT to create a little script that will help us a lot. So let's get started this tutorial. We're going to create a new composition in portrait mode. First, we'll create some text with the first letter. I create it in white. I'm going to use the Alphabet script, part of the LayerGenerators toolset available at ascripts.com website. You can also create all these layers by hand, but it's quicker with our tool. And I'll generate the whole alphabet from this text layer. For your information, my font size is 230. I'm now going to select all my layers. I will center them on the view and duplicate this alphabet 6 times. So why am I duplicating it 6 times? It's more of a question of feeling. I found that 6 times with this size of typography gives good results. Once these layers have been created, we now need to make each layer appear one after the other. I'm going to select everything and drag to the left. Here, my layers only last a single image. And now I'll right-click, Keyframe Assistant, Sequence Layers, and I validate. Now I'll stretch my layers to make this longer again. We'll extend it to about 10 seconds. I think that's going to be pretty good. There, I can see that my layers appear and disappear progressively. So now I have two solutions. I can send all this to Newton, which will make a fairly complex simulation because we've got 150 objects, and these objects are complex because they are typography and it's going to be a bit heavy. I'm going to suggest another solution that works better and is much smoother. I'm going to use a script to create a mask on each object. Why create a mask on each object? Because if I use a rectangular mask, it will greatly limit the number of polygons on each object. And you'll see that, in terms of simulation, it looks really, really good. You don't necessarily need many more polygons. So how do I create this script? Quite simply, with ChatGPT. So I ask it to make a script for After Effects that will create a mask on each selected text layer. Once that's done, I copy the code. I'm going to use this text editor on macOS that does plain text. This is very important. I'm going to save it. I'll call it Add Mask. I'm going to go to my desktop and change the extension to .jsx. I validate, and that's it. And now if I go back into After Effects, I'll select all. That's it, I have a mask on each of my objects. And now if I run Newton, I have rectangular objects. It will be much simpler and much faster. I'm going to make them white. I'm going to put walls on the four sides of my composition. I'm going to cut the gravity. I'm going to increase the sub-steps of my solver to have a more accurate simulation. Here I will use the randomizer on the position between 0 and 100. There, I bring the objects back to the center. I'll apply a randomizer to the rotation between 0 and 360 degrees. Once done, I'll put in a little angular velocity. That way my objects will go a little bit faster in rotation. And that's about it. And now if I look at my simulation, I get this. Perfect. All right then, I'll just render it. So now I have a new composition and it gives me this result. So that's my composition after Newton's simulation. We can stop there, but we can also go further and do this Griffon edge processing that I'm going to do with our Plotter plugin. Note that creating the script to apply the masks takes a little time, but it will be always faster to do this than to run the simulation with all the letters in Newton because there's too much detail in those objects. And here, if you look carefully, you don't see that it's a simulation based on rectangles. So I'm going to take this composition, put it into a new composition, and I'll do my processing with Plotter. I'll have to modify this composition a little. I just need to add a black layer at the very bottom. So I go back to my composition that I'm going to name Plotter. I'm going to get my plugin, apply it, and I get this result. We can take a look at what it looks like with that filter there, boxes. In my example, I've used line draw. So there, you have to invert it to have the lines applied correctly. And we can see that right away, I have a result. I can do a little bit of randomness in my lines. Have something a little bit rougher. There I have all the letters. They are treated in the same way simply because they all have the same luminosity, namely white. So what can we use to make variations? Then either it would have been necessary to create the letters with different luminosities, which could be possible perhaps by using Illustrator or another tool. Here we can also vary simply the transparency. So I use a tool called Randomizer that you can download from ASCript, but there are others and it can make me do some randomization on the opacity property. I'm going to enter values, for example 15 and 100. And now I have text layers that all have different opacity levels. I can go back into Plotter and now you can see that I have a result that's more randomized. We can go a little further. For example, if I have empty text here, what I can do is use levels. There you go. You can have different rendering depending on the levels we'll enter into After Effects. And the last step, we could also use an effect called posterize time. And like this, we can also have an effect that is a little more cartoonish. For example, we can put it on 10 images. It's going to give us something a little more cartoonish. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you liked it.